Thank you for accelerating the world's transition to sustainable energy. There are early adopters. There are those people that forge a path for others. And
yeah, you have to have early adopters.
You do. Yeah. They've got to go first and test out technology and see what works. And Australia, I guess we're always on the back of early adopters. And
we are actually, particularly in cars, I believe that we are. We take up options on cars more so than anyone else in the world. We're great at gadgets, it seems, in the car field at least.
But I'm always mindful when people make a decision about an electric vehicle, it's got to make sense for the individual. Mm. If it doesn't make economic sense or financial sense, or if it's not easier or more convenient, why would you do it?
So, and we're starting to see now people who have looked at the progress of electric vehicles, and really Tesla has led the charge here. History will remember Tesla as the true leaders in this particular area. And now people are seeing that there's a variety of cars available. It's practical. It is really now a practical proposition to have an electric vehicle in your garage.
In people's decision making is range, and range anxiety is a big concern for people. But I think it's a bit of a mindset change when people get an electric vehicle. If you think of it like your mobile phone, do you have range anxiety on your phone, or you just charge it up whenever you can, it up?
We're at the very beginning of this technology, so we will get improvements, and there will be 1,000-kilometre range.
Wouldn't be a week go by where I don't get an article of some new battery technology that they're testing. And remember when computers first kicked off in this country? I mean, you'll remember, you would have seen so many changes in your lifetime, but I remember when computers first kicked off, and it was almost every year they were doubling the output of computers. They were just increasing it at such a pace. And I see the same thing with electric vehicles. Yeah. There's so many new models coming out. And I remember coming back from the fully charged event that I went to at the ICC in Sydney recently, and came away from that just having deja vu back to the late 80s, early 90s, going to the same venue or similar venue before I upgraded it in Sydney, and seeing all the groups starting and the people showing their wares and what's the latest in computers. Back in those days, there were these clubs that were set up all over Australia where people were getting into PCs, and the same thing's happening with electric vehicle. All these clubs have started up where people are doing conversions and electric vehicles is a really exciting space, and hats off to all the early adopters and those forging a path and getting vehicles, because they then sell those vehicles. They either hold on to them for a long time, or they sell those vehicles and they become secondhand.
Yeah. It is a sensible decision now. I think we've moved beyond the very early adopters, and where it's not quite mainstream yet, but it's becoming more and more mainstream. I mean, the ads on television and media for electric vehicles are popping up and popping up. The tide is definitely turning, and it's going to become quite rapid in the very near future.
Congratulations if you've bought an electric vehicle, you've got one coming. So you probably want to look at, how am I going to charge this thing at home? Because there are places where you can charge out while you're about, shopping centres, and there are destination chargers starting to pop up. But being able to charge at home is probably the base where people want to be able to charge. So the worst possible time to use an electric device in Australia at the moment is at 6 o'clock at night.
Dinner
time is the worst. So if there's something that you can do to push your usage back, either through a battery or through time of use or scheduled charging, same goes for electric vehicle. Yeah. If you cannot do it at 5, 6 o'clock, the Gen 3 is a little bit smaller than the Gen 2. It's got a very nice glossy, almost, I think it's probably plastic. Oh, it could be glass. Glass type face on it, and the cable. So that's probably some information there that is important to keep and remember. There's a QR code on there and information with serial numbers and all sorts of stuff. So usually
is this a single phase or a three phase or what?
Well, good thing about the Teslas is it's the same unit, whether you connect
it
up single or three phase. So yeah,
our Frontius approach.
Yep, yes. Same thing. So same unit can be connected with single or three phase. Obviously three phase, you can use it a bit quicker. Most of the time, so this charging is AC charging. It's not AC charging, and most of the vehicles have a limit of what they can accept.
That's right. Their internal AC-DC battery charger in the vehicle is limited.
And a lot of them are 11 kilowatts.
Yeah, that's right.
Some of them might go a little bit higher. I think the fastest that I've seen with the AC chargers is 22 kilowatts, but majority of vehicles out there is 11 kilowatts. Mm. So when we connect this and commission it, and you do that with the QR code and Wi-Fi, you connect it to Wi-Fi, as the installer, you can dial in the amount of amperage, the max amperage you want to set this unit at. If you're in a multi-residential area or you've got multiple chargers, you can have them work together and share the amount of power as well. So, we've got an install coming up.
The interface is through your phone, is it?
Yeah, Wi-Fi connection on your phone, and then also the vehicle or the vehicle app.
Yeah.
So if you, for instance, had a Tesla, you can use the app that you monitor your vehicle and you can program when you would like it to turn on and charge. So why would you go this if you've got power at home, want to charge the vehicle up? It can put in about 70 kilometers range in an hour. Mm-hmm. So for most people, I would say 70 to 100 kilometers is probably what they're doing a day. So for most people, they're going to be able to top up within an hour.
Yeah.
And if you use your car's software, you could say you get home, plug it in, but say don't charge until those cheaper rates kick in or 8-9 o'clock at night.
And it's very good too that it can be configured as three phase or single phase.
Yeah. Some houses obviously have access to three phase, especially if they're running an air conditioner, a big air conditioning unit. Some houses we see have three phase. A lot of people got single phase. So,
well, we've had people calling us and saying, look, we've got an electric car. And a lot of them are very knowledgeable, actually. They say, I want this brand of charger or that.
Cheap, does the job, works great. I reckon they're subsidising that. I don't think they could probably build that for $750. No. So,
I think in a lot of ways Tesla are not out at the moment to make a fortune out of things. They're looking to have a plan to populate the planet with electric vehicles, and they're going about it the right way. I mean, they started out with a spectacular Model S, and now they're going down to the cooking models that they need for mass adoption.
So they've made these Tesla chargers now. Is a setting, you can restrict it, you can put it to all vehicles, Teslas only, or specific vehicles. So you can even put a little bit of a security in there and say, only allow this one vehicle to charge and nothing else will work. So we can do that in the app that we set it up. We can make it open for everybody or only Teslas or a specific car. So there you go. Now everybody can use the Tesla charger. So
it's pretty cheap.
It is cheap. So I think as time goes on and more EVs hit the market, more retailers will have a discounted rate for EV charging. So probably a separate circuit is another thing to discuss when people...
Yes, well, that's right. All these require a dedicated circuit.
Yep.
Yeah, so they're not designed to be plugged into an ordinary power point.
Yeah, so we find a space in the switchboard. We put a RCD or a breaker, a safety switch in, and then we connect up the EV charger onto its own circuit. That's why you're not tripping the power if you're trying to run the pool pump or something else on the same unit.
Yeah.
Interesting days, EV charging and getting people set up. We're here to help.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Righto. Thanks for watching the videos, and please like, share or tag a friend, and head to our webpage. You can see lots of articles. There's download section with lots of ebooks where you can download some of this information. I picked this guy's brain and we get him to write articles for us.
You've been picking him so much, I haven't got any
left. He writes articles for us and then we make them into ebooks and they're free to download. So you're just a wealth of knowledge, Franks. But anyway, that's the Tesla Gen 3 wall charger.